In this video, we're going to walk through solving a problem using the false position method in Microsoft Excel. So, our problem states, to find the root of the following function using the false position method to an error level of 0.05. Our function here is 4x squared plus 3x minus 3. Just as a quick note, if you missed our previous video on the theory behind the false position method, I will leave a link in the description below for you to check that out first. Just remember that the false position method is used to find the roots of nonlinear equations. So, to begin, let's create some headers for our table. Let's just assume that A is going to be our lower boundary input, and B is going to be our higher boundary input. C is going to be our new value, that is our new step, and we'll talk about that in a little bit. But it is found based off our A and B values. F of A, F of B, and F of C will just be the outputs of our function at these specific inputs. Next, we need a column that determines which of the two outputs, f of a times f of c, or f of b times f of c, gives a negative value, and this will tell us which direction we need to move, whether left or right. Then lastly, we need to calculate the error at any given iteration. And for the false position method, this can be done using ci plus 1, so our current iteration plus 1, minus our current iteration of c. And that'll make sense here shortly. Now, for this first iteration, we need to assign A and B values based on what we found in our positive or negative product test that we performed in the previous iteration. To accomplish this, we're going to use a simple if statement. So, to do so, we type equals if, and then a logical statement, so that means something that will either be true or false. So, we select the value given by f of a times f of c, and test if this is less than 0. If true, then that means our root is to the left of c, and a will remain unchanged, whereas b will take on the c value. If false, then the root is to the right of c, and a will take on c's value. We repeat the same formula for our higher root boundary, b. Now, we are free to bring down all other rows. Every time we create a new row like this, we are basically iterating another step, much like we did in the previous video by hand, except this method, using Excel, is much faster. As you can see here, after only a few iterations, our error term is already lower than our acceptable value, which means that we are done. And another thing to note is that with the bisection method, solving for the root of this function took us 5 iterations, whereas here it is less than that. And this is usually consistent with the false position method. It is often much quicker than the bisection method. We could also visually depict our function and the boundaries in the following way. Let's create small steps in the x direction. Let's say 0.01, and we go from our initial bounds of 0 to 1. Then, beside this, we can apply these inputs to our function and get the outputs. Next, we can graph the function and visually see that we do indeed have a root between these two points, 0 and 1. Next, let's just create a line in our graph and show where our current iteration of the false position method places us in relation to the root. And there you go, we have just completed a problem using the false position method in Microsoft Excel. One additional thing that is cool to add is a validation that we do have a root within our two boundaries. So to accomplish this, let's create an if-or statement, which states that if f of a times f of c, or f of b times f of c, and just note the syntax here, is less than 0, we print true. There is at least one root present, and if it is false, we print that. The only times this could give you trouble is if you have more than one root present within your boundaries, and you can ensure that doesn't happen simply by graphing the function like we just previously did. So, just as a final note, you can really use this Excel sheet you just created to solve for any function that you want to solve using the false position method. All you need to do is adjust the formula here for f of a and copy and paste that into f of b, f of c, and f of x for iteration 0 and 1 here. Copy and pasting here works, as in this formula, our input term is always just to the left of the cell that we are solving for, which is the output for that given input. Then, lastly, you just adjust your boundaries A and B to contain a single root within them. This may take some adjusting, but can easily be done through plotting the function like we did earlier. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of how we find the roots of a function through the false position method in Microsoft Excel. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our Patreon page to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.